Always gives me a great sense of joy to be able to simply witness monks debate. Imagine this happening in a typical monastic courtyard where literally hundreds of monks are doing their small clusters. And then as initially when the class begins, you know, there's only two persons, one sitting down and one standing up. But as kind of the class moves on, then there's a certain kind of natural kind of congregation, small congregations here and one in another corner and some over there. And then some of the monks who feel that the defender is, you know, has a point will join the defender and help defend the position. And those who feel that the defender is saying really outrageous things, and nobody should get away with saying these kind of things, will join the attacker's side. And you have these two sides shouting. You know, you may not be able to follow the language, but you could feel the energy, and the energy picks up. As the exchanges get more intense, the voices rise higher. And one of the amazing things about this particular experience of debating is that even in this, in a kind of congregation of many monks screaming at each other in this, you know, in these two directions, the clarity of thought and the focus is amazing. The main learning takes place in the debating courtyard. And there is, underlying this is a certain philosophy of the process of acquisition of knowledge. Knowledge is transmitted not in the form of an expert instructor who is passing on knowledge in the form of information to the student. Rather, knowledge emerges in a dialogical process where exchanges among equals, students, colleagues, occur based on, of course, a certain set amount of information that you need. And a really good instructor really sees his or her role not so much as passing on finished conclusions to the students, but rather to help, you know, teach the process of thinking. And also in the debate tradition, one of the things that is often aimed at is what is called, gaining mastery over the path of reasoning. Now, this is a phrase, Riglam Chakpa. You know, Riglam Chakpa is to gain mastery of the path of reasoning. So the students may be struggling at the initial stage. You know, you learn the basic moves, like teaching children the chess moves. In debate, much of the things that the challenger puts across are consequences, implications that are being drawn out from the statement that the defender has given. So in the same way in chess, you know, whatever piece you're going to move is going to set in motion a whole series of implications. It's the same thing with the debate, you know, so that in some sense, the person who is defending sets the course of the discussion, because whatever response the defender gives is going to change the direction to which the debating will go. People differ, you know, and in the Tibetan kind of theory of education, we speak of different aspects or dimensions of intelligence. Swift intelligence, people who are able to think on their feet, quick. So stand-up comedians are fantastic, you know, when it comes to thinking on their feet. So that's a swift intelligence. Then you have clear intelligence. Some people are very clear in their ability to think and articulate in words. So some people are very good at thinking clearly. And then you have penetrating intelligence, where you are able to really follow through, go ever deeper into a point. So that's a penetrating, you know, intelligence. Then some people have what is called the encompassing intelligence or broad intelligence, where they may not be necessarily quick or clear, but they are able to look at things from many different angles. So in the debating courtyard, those who have a tendency to be really good at quick sharpness of mind, they are very good at challenging, because they're able to immediately see a counterexample that they can bring up. And those who are, you know, deeply penetrating and has this broader perspective, they're able to defend positions much better. So what debate does, the ideal is that once you gain this mastery of the path of reasoning, then you really move beyond this set formulas of, you know, responding and exchanging. There's a certain spontaneity that comes up. But initially, it is really tough. You need a lot of discipline, you need a lot of forms, but once you get to a certain stage, then there's a certain spontaneity, there's a fluidity. And that's what a good debater is able to arrive at.
The Buddhists have created something that is a very broad avenue for many. And the point is that that I want to make is that you may not, you know, even if you throw yourself into it completely, you may never be the equal of some of these great scholars from India and Tibet. However, if you learn the skills, you will be better than you would have been otherwise.
Yeah, true.
There
true.
Will be progress.
True.